Yo guys, what is up? My name is Gian and welcome back to FPL Tribe. In this video, we're going to have a quick look at our Game Week 8 scores. As you guys know, I did a wildcard video because I said I was thinking about it. Then when I heard Rafinha's not playing, Jota's not playing, Rudiger's definitely not playing, it came to my mind. I think it was the perfect opportunity just to get new players in for those injured players and just get a... use that wild card that's been bothering us probably since game week 4. So I'll quickly have a look over the team, who we ended up picking, and how the team did in game week 8. We'll also discuss my thoughts on game week 9, the team, and who I'm thinking about captaining. There's two very good options for this week. So if you guys enjoyed the video, give it a like, give me a subscribe, and enjoy. Having a look at our Game Week 8 wildcard team, as you guys can see, we decided to stay with Sanchez. He got us 6 points in a really good game from Brighton. I think Sanchez, over the next couple of games, he might not be the best keeper, but definitely in the long run, I think Sanchez is still the best goalkeeper you can get at 4.5 million. I looked at someone like Ramsdale. In the end, I just don't trust Arsenal's defense. As you guys will see, I've got Tomiyasu, but he's more of a bench filler, and he's a 4.6 million, 4.5, 4.6 million defender that plays constantly, and he plays in one of the better teams that you can get for a 4.5 million defender, and that's why we decided to go with him rather than Ramsdale, because he is going to be on the bench most of the time. Then moving on to Cancelo, really happy we got him, and that he's starting most of the games. He started every game so far for Man City. So can't complain too much of it, having Joao Cancelo, just because for me, he's probably the second best defender in the league behind Trent Alexander-Arnold. As you guys see, we had him as well. Still decided to keep him, even though there was some speculations that he might not be worth it over the next couple of fixtures. I think if you can get a player like Trent, you might just keep him for the rest of the season. He's that good. And coming in at 7.5 million, I think for the... there's a reason he's the most expensive defender. He's almost like having an extra midfielder. So really happy with Trent. Then we went for Reece James instead of Azpilicueta just because we didn't have the money. But looking at it, Azpilicueta and Chilwell is probably one that I'll go for if I have the chance to do it again. Just because I think Chilwell has shown that he's starting now, and he's probably first pick over Alonso. Then Azpilicueta is just the captain. Doesn't matter if he's going to play as that right-sided centre-back or he's going to play right-back. So it's probably in the long run will regret this decision. But James, if he plays, he's probably got the highest ceiling out of all those Chelsea defenders. Then Livramento, he came on for us. As you guys see, Rafinha didn't play. So we actually got two guys in this team that didn't play. Rafinha and Jota just didn't play any minutes in this game week. It worked out nicely for us in the end, because we have Livramento that was on the bench originally. He came in to get us 6 points. I think Livramento being 4.5 million, if you got on him early, I think he's one of the best investments we made into this team. Just because he is a really good player. Southampton looking very good in defense. So I'm really happy to have him as my first bench option, just for in case someone doesn't play. And moving on to our midfield, Saka, 0 points. Really disappointed, and I hope he's not injured for too long, just because he went off at halftime in that game. I don't know if you guys saw it, but he got kicked really hard. And I don't know how there wasn't a red card involved. But just before he got kicked and got that injury, he made a silly tackle to get a yellow card. So not too happy with Saka, but let's hope he's fit for this next couple of games that Arsenal have. Then captain Mo Salah, I think probably the best player in the world for me right now, definitely in the Premier League. Just scoring against anyone, and really happy we had him, as it was a little bit of a decision between him and Lukaku that played against Brentford, but really happy to have Salah as my captain for this game week. Then moving on to Tony, as you guys can see, we did decide to get rid of Mikel Antonio. I think in the long run, it's going to work just because Tony has such good fixtures coming up, and the way they played against Chelsea, he's really unlucky not to get a return out of that game. So I think there's still a lot of points coming from Tony. Then Jimenez, I think over the next couple of fixtures, he's probably one of the best strikers and he will get a lot of points for us. So really happy with him, even though it was a little bit shocked, because I think if you look at that Wolves team, he's probably the one player you'll think he's playing 90 minutes every game. I know he was on international duty, was a little bit fatigued, and that's why he got benched. But let's hope he starts again in the next game. Then Lukaku, really struggling this season. Not this season, but the last couple of games. I know there's some talks that he's mentally tired and physically tired and he needs a rest. So we'll be looking at the Champions League game to see if he starts. I think he's a really good player to have with the fixtures that Chelsea have. But you want your, if you pay 11.5, 11.6 million for a player, you want him to score. And that's exactly what we want from Big Romelu. So not upset with the decision yet, but we'll see how it works out in the long run. Then Rafinha, as we said, came back from international duty. Thought he was going to play. We did have him in the starting lineup, but didn't come up for any minutes. Then Jota didn't play any minutes against Watford. I think the only reason we kept Jota is because we had that fixture against Watford. If it wasn't such a good fixture for a player like Jota, even if he comes off the bench, he can still get you a goal, still get you an assist. So that's probably someone we'll be looking to move out, as we'll get to later. And then Brownhill, always probably going to be in our third position on the bench, but just really happy to have him there for when someone doesn't play, he can come up and get you those 2 points. And now we'll have a look at our Game Week 9 team. I think the team that we had from Game Week 8 is still looking really good. So not going to consider too many changes, but we'll get to them. Sanchez in goal, playing against Man City. And that's why I said maybe over the next couple of fixtures, he might not be the best goalkeeper. But goalkeeper is someone I don't want to spend a transfer on. So I'm happy to keep Sanchez even in these difficult games. Hopefully he can get some save points. This is probably one of the games where we'll need to make extra saves and he might get some save points. So if he gets a clean sheet, he's definitely going to be in the bonus points as well, just because he's going to need to make a lot of saves in that game if the clean sheet comes. Then Trent Alexander-Arnold play against Man United. Probably not the best game to play or defender to have in your team when they're playing against Man United, just because Man United not playing the best football at the moment, but the attack still looking really good, and with Cristiano Ronaldo there, they can always get a goal. But Trent Alexander-Arnold's like basically an extra midfielder, so someone I'll be looking to keep probably for the rest of the season. Then João Cancelo, if he plays, I think the clean sheet is definitely on against Brighton. The only worry I have with him, he played 90 minutes in Champions League last night, so not too sure if he'll start again. But if he does, he's a really good option, and we have cover on the bench if he doesn't come on. Then Reece James, we'll see if he plays in the Champions League. I think if he doesn't play in the Champions League on Wednesday night, he's a really good option, because I think he will play on that right wing-back spot. And then I can see him getting an assist, maybe getting a goal from a free kick and getting a clean sheet. So then we're looking at 10 to 12 points that I'll be really happy with, and probably a couple of bonus points. Then Livramento against Burnley. The only reason we're considering Livramento is, as you guys will see, Saka is on the bench. So if Saka... if we hear anything from Arteta that Saka is fit, I'll probably put Saka in the midfield and Livramento, have him on our bench to cover Cancelo or James if they don't play. But before I hear any news, I'll rather go with Livramento, and even considering playing Livramento if Saka is fit, just because he's looked so good, Burnley not looking good, and Southampton, the defense is looking pretty solid. So someone I'm really considering to even play this week. Then moving on to the midfield, as you guys can see, Mo Salah playing against Man United. Probably someone we need to think about more about captaincy, but I just think, well, I'll speak about Romelu a little bit later, but I just think he's the better captaincy option. But Mo Salah is in such good form at the moment, scoring in every single game. I think he's scored 9 games in a row now, including in the Champions League that he played last night. So really someone that's in pretty good form at the moment, and I think you should consider captaining probably every game if possible. But I just think I'm a fixture manager, and with someone else having a better fixture, probably not in a better form, but it's definitely the better fixture if you go between Man United and Norwich. Then Rafinha, I'm 100% sure he will start this game. He just didn't play because he came back late from international duty. So against Wolves, I can really see him putting up a big score for us, just because Wolves, as we saw in the previous game against Aston Villa, Wolves is a really difficult team, because they look like one of the best teams in the league for 10 minutes, and then they look like one of the worst teams in the league for the next 10 minutes. So really hard to say where I stand on Wolves. So I can really see Rafinha getting a couple of returns here just because we know how good he is. And he's probably, I think he's going to be in the top 10 point scorers at the end of this season. So really happy to have him. Then one of our transfers will get definitely want to get rid of Jota just because Liverpool is having a couple of difficult fixtures and he's not guaranteed to start. If you spend 7 million or 7.5 million on a player, I want someone that I will definitely start. And that's why we've bringing in Mbeumo. I don't know how you pronounce his name, but someone with, that has the fixtures and playing in midfield. But when he plays for Brentford, he plays more as a striker, the most advanced striker, if I can say it like that. So really just happy with having him there. And I expect over the next 3 or 4 game weeks for him to really have an impact on this team and probably outscore players like Lukaku or Jimenez, because Lukaku's also got really good fixtures. So for 5.5 million, I think it's someone you need, you definitely need in your team. Then Ivan Toney, same goes for him that I said for Mbeumo. He's probably going to get more assists because he is the one that's getting those flick-on headers and keeping the ball for Mbeumo to make the run and trying to get him in on goal. But he is on penalties, and we saw he's really good aerial threat. So off corners, he's probably the one guy that will get his head onto the ball and score a header goal. So really happy to just have Toney as well in my team. Then Lukaku, now coming to, let's talk about a little bit about captaincy. Lukaku probably not in the best form, but Chelsea still playing pretty good. I think he has been unlucky so far not to score in the previous game and the game before that against Southampton. Could have had an assist, had a goal, but it was offside. I think last week he was also unlucky not to score. So I think the goals is definitely coming. And if you want someone that's out of form and you want him to score a couple of goals, what better fixture than Norwich at home? So I really think Romelu is going to get some points out of this game, and that's why the captaincy armband is still on him. Well, yeah, if he might get a race, that's will obviously want to change it to Mo Salah just because Mo Salah has been in such good form. And then Jimenez against Leeds, I think anytime you can get an attacker against Leeds, you need to start him and you really need to consider him to be your captain just because Leeds' defense is so leaky at the moment. So I think Jimenez, really good option. And like I said, I'm happy to have him in my team for the next 4 or 5 weeks just because they have that really good fixtures before we'll probably try and get rid of him and bring Antonio back. Because Antonio, I think, is a really good player. But with having the Europa League and having a couple of difficult fixtures, I thought it was the right time to get rid of him, even if you're losing a little bit of money if we want to get him back. So Jimenez is there, and I think against Leeds, he's definitely going to bring us in some points. Then Saka, as already discussed with Livramento, he's just on the bench because he's an injury doubt at the moment. We'll hear later on in the week what Arteta says about that, and then we'll see if he's going to stay on the bench. Like I said, I'm not unhappy to play Livramento against Burnley as well. Then Tomiyasu going to be second on the bench just because I think Aston Villa will score against Arsenal. So not a fixture that I'll want my defender to play in just because it's not too attacking. So you're not necessarily going to get too many attacking returns from him and really just looking for clean sheets from him. And I just think he's not going to keep on against Aston Villa. Then Brownhill against Southampton. Probably someone will need to look at or consider in that Saka position just because Southampton, like I said, they've looked better over the last couple of weeks, but not the best defense if you look over the whole season. So Brownhill, probably someone we would consider, but I think for now I'm happy to have him on my bench. So guys, that's it from me for this video. If you enjoyed it, give it a like, give me a subscribe. I'm really enjoying bringing you guys this videos, something to keep me busy during the week. So like I said, not 100% sure that this will be the team. I'm probably looking to bring Mbeumo in for Jota if we don't have any other injuries in this midweek Champions League and Europa League games. But then the other big decision there is also the captaincy between Lukaku and Salah. I'm still not 100% sure who I'm going to captain between them. Just Salah is in such good form at the moment, so he's always a captaincy option. But then Romelu Lukaku has really got the fixtures to score big this game week. So I think for now I'm happy with the team that I showed you guys. If you guys have a different captain in mind, drop it down in the comments. I would love to hear from you guys. And good luck with your game week 9. Cheers, guys.